Early next morning of the spring of day, up rose our host, and roused us like a cock, and gathered us together in a flock, and off we rode, at slightly faster pace than walking, to St. Thomas' watering place. And while our host watered his horse at ease, he said,
"Now, gentlemen, listen, if you please. Let me recall your promise made to me. If Evensong and Matins will agree, let's see who shall be first to tell his tale. And as I hope to drink good wine and ale, I'll be your judge. The rebel who disobeys, however much the journey costs, he pays. Now draw the cut, and then we can depart. The man who draws the shortest cut shall start. Sir Knight, my master, step up here to me and draw your cut, for that is my decree. And come you near, my lady prioress. And you, Sir Cleric, drop your shamefulness, no studying now, a hand from every man." Immediately the draw for lots began. And to tell shortly how the matter went, whether by chance or lot of accident, the truth is this: the cut fell to the knight, which everybody greeted with delight, and tell his tale he must, as reason was, because of our agreement, and because he too had promised. What was there more to say? For the good man perceived how matters lay, and by discretion and obedience driven to keep the promise he had freely given, he said, "Well, since it's I to start the game, why, welcome be the cut in God's good name. Now let's ride on, and hearken what I say." And at the word, we started on our way, and in a cheerful style he then began to tell his tale at once, and thus it ran.